shelter of the Lord, who abides in his shadow for life. Say to the Lord, my refuge, my rock, in whom I trust, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Good morning, everybody. And I welcome you to St. John's Church this morning for the funeral mass of Patsy Connolly of Doon Road. And we offer our sincerest sympathies to Patsy's family, to his daughters Marie, Noreen, Carmel, Linda, Caroline, Elaine, and Joanne. To his sons-in-law, his grandchildren, great-grandchildren, to Jackie, his brother, his sisters-in-law, nieces, nephews, relations, and his many friends. And as well as offering you our sincere sympathies, of course, we've come to pray for the happy repose of his soul. And we include in our prayer, of course, his wife Joan and their daughter Anne, who died as an infant, and his brothers Tommy and Mickey. But before we begin Mass, we bring some symbols of Patsy's life. You may be seated, please. And Chloe will come forward and introduce the symbols for us and those who are bringing them forward.
Leon brings this poster advertising a concert by the Big Beats from the 1960s. Grandad's first band represents his lifelong love of music. Ben brings a bottle of Guinness, which represents Grandad Pops' love of the black stuff. Adam brings an electric multimeter. This symbolizes his many years as an electrician. Jack brings an accordion, which represents Grandad's famously fast polka set. Willow brings a cushion on which Grandad Pops' beloved dog Lily is pictured, who came into Grandad's life 4 years ago and brought him such joy.
Thank you, Zoe. So you might stand again, please, for the prayer of the Mass. And my brothers and sisters, in preparation for the prayer of the Mass, we take a moment and ask God's mercy on our own lives. So together, I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sin, and bring us to everlasting life. Achilna den trochera. A Christ den Trokera, a Hirna den Trokera. Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant Patsy Connolly, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. So we be seated for the Word of God, and the Word of God will be read by Jade and Elizabeth.
Reading from the prophet Isaiah, on this mountain the Lord of hosts will make for all peoples a feast of rich food. On this mountain he will remove the mourning veil covering all peoples and the shroud enwrapping all nations. He will destroy death forever. The Lord will wipe away the tears from every cheek. He will take away his people's shame everywhere on earth, for the Lord has said so. That day it will be said, "See, this is our God in whom we hoped for salvation. Salvation is the one in whom we hoped. We exult and rejoice that he has saved us." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The response.
The Lord's my shepherd, I not want. He makes me down to lie in pastures green. He leadeth me to quiet waters by. My soul he doth restore again, and me to walk that may within of righteousness, ere far his own name say. Goodness and mercy all my life shall surely follow me, and in God's forevermore my dwelling place shall be.
Happy are those who die in the Lord. I, John, heard a voice from heaven say to me, "Write down, happy are those who die in the Lord." Happy indeed, the Spirit says. Now they can rest forever after their work, since their good deeds go with them. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.
It is my Father's will, says the Lord, that whoever believes in the Son shall have eternal life, and that I shall raise him up on the last day.
Alleluia. Alleluia.
Be with you.
With your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God still, and trust in me. There are many rooms in my Father's house. If there were not, I should have told you. I am going now to prepare a place for you, and after I have gone and prepared you a place, I shall return to take you with me, so that where I am, you may be too. You know the way to the place where I am going. Thomas said, Lord, we do not know where you are going, so how can we know the way? Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except through me. The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated for a few minutes. Thank you. And again, I offer my sincere sympathies to all of Patsy's family. And I know that Patsy had a long and fruitful life. And we acknowledge that here today, and we acknowledge particularly who he was for all of you. But I know as I'm speaking that, look, it can't be easy for you to let go of your father, grandfather, great-grandfather, brother, father-in-law. Just it can't be easy to do that. And I'm just so aware of that here today. And I'm also aware that, look, my words here won't fill the void in your hearts that has been created by Patsy's passing. And I know that Linda will deliver the eulogy when the prayers are complete. But I want to try and put his life into the context of Christianity here this morning. And our parish records, there is great wisdom in the parish records, but we have them, and they show that Patrick Joseph Connolly was born 1932 on the 8th of August to Thomas Connolly and Elizabeth Dillon. I suppose the surprising thing in this stage is that 5 days after that, 5 days, he was brought here for baptism on the 13th of August, baptized by a Father Charles O'Leary. Godparents were Timothy McCarty and Bridget Dillon. I'm told he was one of four boys. And what his baptism did, and what all baptism does, is of course welcome him into the Connolly family, into the Ballybunion community. But what really happens is that he was welcomed into the worldwide Christian community. And there's no person here this morning that was there at his baptism, but two things that were constant. The lighted paschal candle here. There was a lighted paschal candle for baptism all those years ago. And the Bible was read from at his baptism. And we read again today from the Bible. He went to the boys' school. He was confirmed in 1945. By Bishop Michael O'Brien on the 6th of June. And again, to put that in context, that was 3 months before the end of the Second World War. Second World War finished in September that year. Just to put it into context for you and for ourselves. And as we see in the symbols, after school he became an electrician. I'm told he had an apprenticeship with the ESP. Then some stage he went to England, where he met Joan from Fetterton, Tipperary. And again, our records have a record of that, that he was married 1955 in St. Albans and Hearts. They came back to Ballybunion, had 8 daughters, the joy of their lives. And although an electrician was his trade, his passion and his interest was music, which played a huge part in his life. He played many instruments, the accordion, the organ. He became very well known all over Munster. And as the poster tells us, he played and sang with the big beats, great for waltzes and sets. Look, we give thanks for all his talents, for who he was for the wider community, for you, for the people all over Munster. Above all, I want to give thanks for who he was for his family. believe he was a doting father on all of you, that he was very kind and generous. He was a great grandfather and a great grandfather. So his legacy really is his love, especially for his 7 remaining daughters, his 11 grandchildren and 8 great grandchildren. Just a wonderful legacy of life and love. Joan died 5 years ago, and their daughter Anne died as a baby. We gather here in the church to proclaim that Patsy's love will be transformed and that his life of love will live forever in heaven. And the words of the gospel that we read here was that there are many rooms in my Father's house. In other words, there's room for all of us. And our prayer, and the promise of that prayer is the light of Paschal candle. Our prayer is that God will breathe life of resurrection for Patsy, and that he will live forever in heaven with his loved ones. May he rest in peace. Amen. Might stand, please, for the prayer of the faithful. And can I invite those of you who are praying the prayers of the faithful for us, please, to come forward. Thank you.
Let us pray for all those who mourn Pops' death. Lord, we ask you to comfort them in their sorrow, fill their emptiness in their hearts with the presence of your everlasting love. Bless them and wipe away their every tear. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We give thanks for the love which Grandad showed during his life. May he know the perfection and fulfillment of that love in heaven. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We remember all those who have died, especially Grand John, their beloved daughter Anne, Granddad's brothers, Tommy and Mickey, his beloved niece, Mary, and nephew, Tom. May they enjoy the promise of eternal happiness. Lord, hear us.
We pray for the sick, especially the burden of the serious illness, and for those who share their sufferings, caring for the sick at home and in hospital, that all may know the strength of Christ's presence with him in their time of need. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For all of us gathered here today, and for those that could not be here, may we all remember the joy that Grandad brought to all of our lives through his love of music and song. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
And I want to include in our prayer as well Mrs. Fitzgerald of Main Street, who died this morning, and her funeral arrangements will be announced later. So may her soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. You can be seated, please. And the bread and wine will be brought to the altar table for the prayer of the Eucharist. Noel will lead us in the offertory hymn.
In bread we bring you, Lord, our bodies labor. In wine we offer you our spirit's grief. do not ask you, Lord, who is my neighbor, but stand united now in one belief. Oh, we have gladly heard your word, your holy word, and now in answer, Lord, our gifts we bring. Our selfish hearts make true our failing faith renew. Our lives belong to you, our Lord and King.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands and praise the glory of his name for our good and good of all his church.
As we humbly present to you these offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Patsy Connolly, we ask your mercy that Patsy, who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Saviour, may find in him a great welcome in heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Raise them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
Right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him, the hope of resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended, and when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." In song, the mystery of faith.
He is Lord, he is Lord, he is risen from the dead, and he is Lord. Every knee shall bow, every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your people spread throughout the world. Bring us to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Ray, our Bishop, and all who serve you. Remember your servant, Patsy Connolly, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that Patsy, who was united with your Son, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen. 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 Amen.
Might stand, please, and together we pray the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, rather look on our faith. Graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Peace of the Lord be with you always." Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who were called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you under my roof. Only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body of Christ bring us to everlasting life. Amen. And for communion, just for the safety of everybody, I will offer communion to this block first, and then I will come over to this side for you. Thank you.
even though the rain hides the stars, even though the mist swirls the hills, even when the dark clouds veil the skies, you are by my side. Even when the sun shall fall in sleep, even when at dawn the sky shall be, even in the night when the storm shall rise, you are by my side. You are by my side. Bright the stars at night that mirrors heaven's way to you. Bright the stars in light where dwelt in love and hope and truth. Even though the rain hides the stars, even though the mist swirls the hills, even when the dark clouds veil the skies, you are by my side. You are by my side. Bright the stars at night that mirrors heaven's way to you. Bright the stars in light where dwelt in love and hope and truth. Even though the rain hides the stars, even though the mist swirls the hills, even when the dark clouds veil the skies, you are by my side. You are by my side.
Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, Patsy Connolly may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Might stand, please, for the prayers of final commendation and farewell, and that will be followed by the poem and the musical tribute and the eulogy. Thank you. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother Patsy May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. And we take just a few moments in quiet prayer for the repose of the soul of Patsy. And as we do so, we reverence his remains with holy water and with incense. Our response to the prayer is, receive his soul and present him to God, the Most High. Saints of God, come to his aid. Hasten to meet him, angels of the Lord. May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord. Let perpetual light shine upon him. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother Patsy in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon him in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our companionship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn towards us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to Patsy and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with Patsy forever in heaven. Amen. Might be seated, please, and we will read the poem.
We little knew that morning that God was going to call your name. In life we loved you dearly, in death we do the same. It broke our hearts to lose you. You did not go alone, for part of us went with you the day God called you home. You left us peaceful memories. Your love is still our guide. And though we cannot see you, you're always at our side. Our family chain is broken, and nothing seems the same, but as God calls us one by one, the chain will link us again.
Thank you. Thank you. And Jerry and Adam will song. Thank you.
This was Patsy's favorite song, and Adam and I are going to attempt it. We sang it together many times, Patsy and I. And if you'd like to join in the chorus and give us a hand, we'd appreciate it.
Oh, the sky was clear, the morning fair. No breath came over the sea. When Mary left her father's home and wandered forth with me, all flowers deck the mountainside, and fragrance fill the vale.
By far the sweetest flower there was the rose of Allendale.
Sing it with us, come on.
Sweet rose of Allendale. Sweet rose of Allendale. By far the sweetest flower there was the rose of Allendale. Where'er I wander to east and west, the faith began to love, consoling still she to me in sorrow's lonely hour. Oh, tempest wrecked my lonely boat, and it wrecked her quivering sail. One maiden fond withstood the storm, 'twas the rose of Allendale. Sweet rose of Allendale. Sweet rose of Allendale, one maiden fond withstood the storm, 'twas the rose of Allendale. And when my fevered lips are parched on Africa's burning sands, she whispered hopes of happiness and tales of foreign lands. My life has been a wilderness, unblessed by fortune's gain. Had fate not linked my love to hers, sweet rose of Allendale. Sweet rose of Allendale. Sweet rose of Allendale. My love to hers, sweet rose of Allendale. Had faith not linked my love to hers, sweet rose of Allendale.
The eulogy, please. Yeah, thank you.
We would like to share with you today the life of an amazing father, grandfather, great-grandfather, musician, and friend, often affectionately known as Pops. Dad was born on the 8th of August, 1932, to Liz and Tom Connolly. He had three brothers, Mickey, Tommy, and Jackie. Dad's love of music started at an early age and was shared by all his brothers, there was always an accordion at their home in East End. He joined the local pipe band along with his brother Tommy, which was founded by Dr. Hannon. Himself and his brother Jackie then joined the Big Beats, and they played all the local dance halls. During the 70s and 80s, Dad spent many summer seasons in Stevie Brosnan's before forming the Melody Aces, and was well known all around the top dancing spots in Munster and beyond. Dad moved to England, where he met Mam at the Bamba Dance Hall, Kilburn, in 1954. According to Dad, it was love at first sight. They married the following year in St. Albans and later returned to Ballybunion. Mam and Dad had 8 daughters. Sadly, they lost their beloved daughter Anne in 1965. He was a kind, generous, and loving father, grandfather, and great-grandfather. He had a great sense of humor and was always up for a laugh, even at his own expense. Dad worked all his life as an electrician. He was well known as an early riser, and we often heard stories from starting jobs at the crack of dawn, resulting in him rousing people out of their beds so to get an early start in the job. We were very proud, and he was chuffed to be recertified as an electric contractor at 80. He just wasn't ready to retire. Dad had his own particular ways, including being at least half an hour early for everything, pacing up and down the sitting room while jiggling coins in his pocket, while impatiently waiting for one of us, whilst muttering under his breath. Having an iron grip of the TV remote, even as he slept on the chair, forcing us to watch muted snooker, golf, and horse racing. Driving in first gear for the first 2 miles of every journey, and making to-do lists, including the never-ending list of jobs for his son-in-law, Dennis, who always obliged the chief. Dad had a wide circle of friends and enjoyed meeting up on a Saturday night in Rogue's Corner, putting the world to rights and joining his number one fans for some banter. On any social occasion, he loved to start a sing-song, which invariably resulted in him singing The Rose of Allendale. At Elaine and Mike's wedding last August, Dad surprised us all by singing what was to be his last rousing rendition. We are so grateful to have that precious memory. Given Dad's musical talent, he was convinced that one of us would follow in his footsteps, and we were entered into every local talent competition, but try as he might, none of us ever reached the dizzy height of his fame. On our annual trips to Mam's hometown of Feathert, we were piled into the back of his van. Dad's idea of air conditioning was leaving the van door open tied open. He would have to make numerous stops along the way, as at least one of us was always travel sick. Never a truer word spoken when they say it's a long way to Tipperary. He idolized his grandchildren and great-grandchildren. Whenever they visited, they were sent away with €2 for sweets, which over the years increased in line with inflation. He used to get a great kick out of teaching them to swear, much to Mam's disapproval. As much as they loved him, he loved them even more, and they brought him great pride and joy. As Mam's health failed, Dad ensured she had the best of care, taking a very central role in looking after her and organizing all of us. He felt her loss deeply when she died in September 2016. We'd like to thank people who have supported us over the last few days. Thanks to Father Hannafin for the lovely service today. Thanks to Noel Nash, to Ger and Adam for their beautiful version of The Rose of Allendale, to Danny Houlihan, and to those who have traveled to be with us. We'd also like to thank our friends and neighbors for their kindness and generosity. In particular, we would like to thank Nealis for his care and affection he has shown to Mam and the Chief down through the years. We are eternally grateful to our sister Caroline for all her years of love and care that she gave to Dad. Since Friday, we've been heartened to hear him described as a true gentleman, a legend, and one of Ballybunion's favorite sons. All terms that would have made him very proud. We are absolutely heartbroken that Pops has taken from us so suddenly, which has left a huge void in all our hearts. The fact that he was 88 does not diminish, only magnifies the enormity of our loss. It's hard to put into words the many ways that we will miss him mostly. We will miss his sharp wit, his welcoming smile, and the huge presence he had in our lives. We will love and miss you every day. Sleep well, our darling Pops.
Jerusalem. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Our brother Patsy has gone to his rest in the peace of Christ. May the Lord now welcome him to the table of God's children in heaven. With faith and hope in eternal life, we assist him with our prayers. We pray to the Lord also for ourselves. May we who mourn be reunited one day with Patsy. Together may we meet Christ Jesus when he who is our life appears in glory. We read in sacred scripture, our true home is in heaven, and Jesus Christ, whose return we long for, will come from heaven to save us. Let us pray. O God, by whose mercy the faithful departed find rest, bless this grave, send your holy angel to watch over it. As we bury here the body of Patsy Connolly, deliver his soul from every bond of sin,
that he may rejoice in you with your saints forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Because Almighty God has chosen to call Patsy from this life to himself, we commit his body to the earth. Dear friends, in reverence, let us pray to God, the source of all mercies. You raise the dead to life, give Patsy eternal life. Lord, have mercy. Lord, you consoled Martha and Mary in their distress. Draw near to all who mourn for Patsy and dry the tears of those who weep. Lord, have mercy. Comfort us in our sorrow. Let our faith be our consolation and eternal life our hope. Lord, have mercy. We pray for Joan and all who are buried in the cemetery. May their suffering be lessened. May their joy be increased. May the light of glory shine on them and may they rest in peace. Lord, have mercy. With longing for the coming of God's kingdom, we pray, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. God of holiness and power, accept our prayers on behalf of Patsy Connolly. Do not count his deeds against him, for in his heart he desired to do your will. As his faith united him to your people on earth, so may your mercy join him to the angels in heaven. Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the sorrowful. You are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people who cry out to you in their need. Strengthen their hope in your lasting goodness. We pray the first glorious mystery of the Rosary, the Resurrection. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. May the prayers of Mary, the Mother of God, who stood by the cross as her son was dying, help all who mourn for Patsy and accompany all of us in our time of need. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord. May he rest in peace. May his soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
No one holding you. Anytime you feel like you can't make it through, remember me, and I will be with you. Every night and every day, I'll be by your side. Just reach out and take my hand, and I will be your guide. Anytime you feel like you can't make it through, remember me, and I will be with you. Remember me whenever you're afraid. Remember me if you have lost your way. Anytime you feel like you can't make it through, remember me. I will be with you. Every night and every day, I'll be by your side. Just reach out and take my hand, and I will be your guide. Anytime you feel like you can't make it through, remember